सहयज्ञा प्रजा सृष्ट्वा पुरोवाच प्रजापतिः अनेन प्रसविष्यध्वं येशवोस्त्विष्ट कामधक प्रोफाउंड डिक्लेरेशन बाय कृष्णा इन द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ द गीता स्केर्सिटी इज मैन मेड अबंडेंस इज गॉड मेड गॉड क्रिएटेड दिस यूनिवर्स based on the principle of abundance. When Bhagavan created the universe, he prescribed yajna as the primary duty of all beings. May you perform yajna, selfless contributory work, and through the performance of yajna, may you sustain prosperity. May you sustain abundance, declares Krishna. Abundance is the principle of profusely giving. Giving more than taking. Devan bhavayatanena te deva bhavayantuvaha parasparam bhavayantaha shreyaha paramavapsyata. Krishna declares, may you please the devas with yajna. Devas here represent the various elements of nature, the various cosmic forces who are divine manifestations, vibhutis of the one supreme Godhead, Sri Krishna Paramatma. Krishna, in chapter 3 of Karma Yoga, he declares, may you please the devas, may you cherish, may you perform yajna and please the devas, and in turn, the devas shall bless you with all bounty. Nourishing each other, may you experience abundance all the time. Parasparam bhavayantaha shreyaha paramavapsyata. There was this disciple who approached his master and said, Master, I would like to know the difference between scarcity and abundance. The guru said, let me take you to the land of scarcity and to the land of abundance for you to know the difference. And then the guru took the disciple to two doors. He opened the first door. And then the disciple saw a large room, and in the center of the room was a large table. At the center of the table, it's a big pot of delicious aromatic soup, and his mouth watered. Around the table were seated different people, all holding spoons with long handles. The long handles of the spoon were strapped to the hands, because of which no one could fold their hands. And the long handles were longer than the arms. So therefore, everyone out there sitting around the bowl of soup, delicious soup, were all famished, malnourished. They could reach out with the long-handled spoon, the soup, but they couldn't carry the spoon filled with soup to their mouths. Looking at the sorry state, the disciple shuddered. And then the guru took the disciple to the next room. He opened the second door and the disciple saw the same setting, the same kind of a table with the same kind of a pot filled with aromatic, delicious soup. And here too, all the people had the same kind of long-handled spoons strapped to their arms. But the difference was, in this room, the people were happy. They were well-nourished, having a good time together. The disciple could not understand. Then the guru clarified. While this is the land of abundance, he said, where while the people could not feed themselves, they learned the art of feeding each other, nourishing each other. Parasparam bhavayantaha shreyaha paramavapsyata. This is the principle of abundance, practicing which, Krishna says, we must nourish each other all the time, profusely giving more than taking, and continue to sustain abundance in life and living. Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanamastu.